Hello everyone, welcome back to Age of Vampires 2 Battles. Alright, so this is the second game me and Steven played. Yeah, it's the second game we played. And, with the other video. I don't know why I had a weird, awkward pause there. Yeah, let's switch over to, oh, we are him, okay. Alright, so we are playing again on Arena with the new AI, not the old original AI. Pretty much the same difficulties, except we cranked it up to hardest, thinking that it'll be a piece of cake. Because last time was not bad at all. Yeah, Steven here is nicely walled in. Go figure. Gotta love the wonderful AI. You gotta love the... great design of these maps. Alright, so we're just gonna crank it into way fast forward. I'm gonna be practicing the sling again. But that's, you know, that's just what I was doing. We were just kinda messing around, kinda. I don't wanna say we were messing around, but it's just kinda what we were doing. It's just a theory. You know, we could maybe do this online semi-successfully against noobs. Granted, we're noobs ourselves, but... yeah. Alright, so here we got the Vikings, our ally. This is Steven. This is me, Alec. This is our ally, Albert the Bear. This is the Spanish player, Orange, our enemy. This is the Franks, enemy player. This is the Japanese enemy player, and this guy is the Huns. He is a real Hun. There's a lot of people that pull off resources to go gather that boar, but that actually works. I might want to take notice of that in the future. Oh, I totally did not see that relic. Yeah, he somehow expected me to be able to build a wall with one missing spot. Yeah, I'm nice enough to build him a gate, so he can actually get out of his base. Because I'm nice like that. I mean, shoot, people are already in the castle age? Holy cow. Alright, so Steven is falling a tiny bit behind. I mean, everyone's pretty much in the castle age. I'm giving him some resources, he's starting to move up. I'm plopping down a second town center. Alright, so we're not gonna pay too much attention to me because, you know, the sling again is on. Yep, and our ally, Albert the Bear, man, I did not see all them relics out there. By the time I even was outside the walls, dude already had like three relics. Dude's got one, he's got quite a few monks. Alright, that was pretty wasted villager, not gonna lie there. So I'm slinging him a few resources, not a whole ton. Dude, you gotta know in Arena that the wolves spawn in pairs of two. You got to know that. This forward, I think he could be building it a little bit closer, but eh, it works. I'm just, trying to build my economy out. I have no wood, I believe, at this point. And he's got a small economy. I'm giving him what I can. Mostly wood. I think he's telling me, he's like, hey man, I need, like, tons of food. So you wanna, like, start giving me some? At least he's got a few upgrades. Dude, build some more barracks! You got 2,000 wood! There you go. You knew I was giving him stuff for no reason. No, I gave him. And I thought I gave him. I thought I was swinging okay. Oh, I did not even realize he had an offensive going here. Against the Spanish. Huskarl's kind of a bad unit to chase down conquistadors with. Maybe not. They have very well-pierced armor. I don't know. It's kind of a... I wouldn't call that a good trade, but... It's definitely a more interesting trade. So everyone's kind of, like, building up military units. Vikings player, crossbowman. Pretty good choice for Vikings. Arbalest would be better. I don't know, but against the Hun cavalry archers, if that's a good choice. I think cavalry archers are a, semi-decent counter to, the archers. Alright, so he's backing off a little bit. Oh, he's trying to lure the conquistadors. He's trying to trick him out. Alright, don't exactly know what he's doing. I think he's trying to split their attention. Yeah, it's... I don't know if those are really a good counter. Uh-oh, and now the French are getting involved. That is a lot of gold miners. Yeah, these new AI are a little bit more aggressive, I guess. And Albert the Baird, it seems like he really went with relics and monks. Yeah, Huskarl's not a good trade for Cavaliers. But, I guess it's working. I mean, I'm slinging him. Oh, they really tried knocking out his forward. Dude, you have all these barracks! Why are you only building out of one? Oh man, our Vikings ally is getting like completely annihilated. He's only got archers and he is facing a Hun player with knights. Ouch. Oh, and they have tons of skirmishers to counter his... Man, no wonder our Vikings ally did not do so good. All this gold being wasted by orange here. Town centers are in ruins. Oh, there you go. He's starting to use more of his barracks. Yeah, there you go, Steven. Knocking out those villagers. Dude, when he got all these I hope he watches this video. My analysis. I had no idea what was going on. I'm just microwing my economy. I am doubling up my walls. Got a big base going and back. In hindsight, I should have built a more defensive wall. We'll see that later. Oh, Albert the Bear's helping out. Good. But yeah, these Huskarls are not a good counter to Paladins. He is sitting on way too many... He has six... I don't know, what is he doing? I want to see what his view is on. Oh, so he queued up 15 out of one barracks. No! What are you doing? Huskarls are not a good match. They have no pierce armor. Or they have no comp. They have two armor. What are these paladins hitting? They're hitting 16 damage per hit. Nah, skip the farms. I know I'm kind of nitpicking, but. Okay, he finally did switch to the correct unit. Except they're not, he's got the right line of units, but these guys have no bonuses whatsoever against knights. Okay, pikes do. But again, 5,000 food, he's not, I don't know what he's doing. I feel like he was distracted. He's worried about this monk when... His forward is getting completely annihilated. He's getting trebbed. I mean, he's got this massive flotilla of resources that I've given him. But he can't maintain a population early over 70. We are getting that AOE2 HD kind of bug though, where your units kind of like glitch out. Oh my gosh, purple and gray are like on fire. I didn't realize that yellow was still alive at this point. Me, I'm just camped up in my base. Albert the bear is doing pretty much the same thing. Okay, he's got halberdiers now. Okay, so you actually could not see them building that barracks there. Alright, so Orange finally resigned. You gotta have all these buildings queued up. Build some more houses, man. You gotta keep the pressure on these AI. That is definitely not what Steven is doing. I don't know if he was just having a bad game. I might want to revisit this and see if we can do better. There was something weird going on in this, though. Watching this replay, he is not playing very well. I don't know if it's because we played the two games back-to-back. Last game, he was spending the resources a lot quicker. I mean, he's not queuing up any more units. What is he? Is he seriously microing these guys down here? Oh no, he's looking up here. But he's not doing anything. I don't know why he'd even bother microing a halberdier when he literally has an ocean of reinforcements flooding in. He has 6,000 food! If I would have known that, I would have built my own army. I mean, I don't know what's going on here with Steven. He must have just been having a rough game or something. I mean, if we were gonna have a time to push in, I think it would have been now. I mean, yellow could have used help. Yellow's tying up purple and gray, though. Okay, so he's finally doing a goth flood again, but he's about to house himself. He's got the wrong units for these French paladins. I mean, again, he's down to 76 units. Just for comparison, what does Gray have? Gray has 285. The Huns have 244. How can the Huns have 244? I thought the Huns had... The Huns don't have to build houses. How can they be housed? Do the Huns have some sort of... I don't know why the Huns can only build 244. That's kind of weird. Oh, and these samurai, man, perfect counter to your Huskarls. Steven, I don't know what's going on with the guy. What's going on with him? I mean, he's not even playing at, like, a fraction of his normal capacity. I mean, dude, you're getting raided. Your forward's being overrun. What are you doing? Why are you trying to flood teal? I mean, yeah, you broke into his base, but You're doing that at the wrong time, man. Your forward's gone. Your base is being overrun. I mean, when the player that's slinging is having to build you defensive walls, I think that, I should have realized at this point I should have cut him off. I mean, I'm pretty sure you guys can tell now that we're doomed. I mean, seriously, there's like 20 gold miners outside your front door. I'm pretty sure you can see that. He can see that! He isn't doing anything! Oh my gosh, man. We're definitely redoing this, and I want to see some better play out of this. Oh my god, you finally crossed 100 population! Oh my god, I wonder what Spirit of the Law or like Zero Empires would say if he saw something like this. I mean, this is kind of bad. Oh, he's finally building houses and getting population. Too little, too late though at this point, Steven. I mean, you have 12,000 food. You should have been using that earlier. Definitely should have been using that earlier. And I'm doubled my walls up for the most part. Seriously, he lets his population get down to 80 before he starts rebuilding. I don't know, he needs to do something better, or he needs to sling me. I think that I could do better. Halberdier should not be targeting the buildings. I don't know what's going on with him. I think he was just having a bad game. The AI realized, I think, that I was slinging him or something. Things are getting bad here. When I said I should have built a wall earlier, that's kind of what I was implying. Oh yeah, and I also have a major offensive outside my walls. Albert the Bear is falling back. The momentum is definitely not in our favor. I'm triple layering my walls. I mean, I have no army. I can't defend myself. Oh, I didn't realize he sent all these units in this far. Dude, what are you doing with them? Oh, he tried to raid Great Purple's economy. Actually, that's a pretty successful raid. There's just too many hand cannoneers attacking me. Holy crap, he finally wakes up. He's spending all the resources I gave him. But it's too little too late at this point. He should have switched to champions once he saw that he was majority facing knights and samurai. Just because the samurai get the bonus against the Huskarls, and the Huskarls have no armor. Well, the champions have more armor, plus don't suffer from the samurai attack bonus. Me, I'm trying to build a great wall to contain them. I mean, there's a lot going on. I will admit that. The wrong unit composition was also another thing that was kind of bad. Now, if you guys actually watch, I am swinging teal at the same, or green at the same time, I believe. Just if we watch for a moment. I believe I do. Yeah, I'm giving him resources too. I have no idea if he's actually using them for anything productive. I was trying to support him and Steven. I mean, as you can see, I am decently slinging. I have no excess resources. I'm trying to build my wall. But I realized that the pathfinding's all off because there's only one way in and out of his base, basically. Those samurai are just tearing us up. I mean, this would be a good spot for some onagers or something. But hey, lessons learned. You learn by a liver. At this point, we pretty much can't hold back their massive offensive. Yeah, I'm sitting there telling him, hey, you wanna like knock down some walls? So we can get some trade going. Yeah, I see gray there, but there's not really anything I can do about it at that point. Just kind of layering up my walls as thick as I can. At this point, I see Steven's pretty screwed, and I think I see the writing on the wall. I mean, it's not looking good. I mean, I even built a small base on the back of his base. But I mean, it's just no good. I was like, hey, I'm gonna try to build another wall to help. I did not realize Purple was sneaking a villager in there. Two villagers, actually. I wonder what those were for. And they're about to gun off my villager. I believe. And the Gothic Flood's pretty much out of resources. I think at this point we're pulling a full-scale retreat just about out of his base. Elbert the Bear is pretty much gone. Actually, he's got more stuff than I thought he would at this point. He still got his three relics, which I think was helping him. 56,000 wood, dude. I don't know what the trading rates were, but I think I told you that you could sell some of it or something. We're Skyping, just if it doesn't look like we were talking. We were talking, we were Skyping. I mean, oh my god. I am like, dude, you gotta pull back. We are done. I'm telling him you have to build a new market for trade. I mean, we were just getting annihilated. I mean, I'm still slinging him with everything I got, but I have no gold income at this point. I should probably put some new mills down. But hey, I'm still... It's not like he really needs the wood, though. He has 59,000. And yeah, things just aren't looking very good for us. At this point, we're a little doomed. And he's really about to get housed once I knock all these down. As we see, they're very quick to do. Albert the Bear has finally been annihilated. I'm like, holy crap, we are under attack on this side. I think we're going to, I think at this point I'm actually even going to build a couple military units, because I have, we don't really have a choice. Clearly me slinging him has not done the greatest job ever. And he is also massively housed. I don't know why at this point I'm even giving him wood. I didn't realize he had 70,000. Not that I needed it. I was definitely making a lot more than I needed. I mean, what did I actually have? I had 108 lumberjacks, 46 farmers, 7 trade units, and 11 idle villagers. Actually, I had a lot more trade units than that at one point. But, yeah. That is, there we go. But yeah, as you can see, the front gate's about to be breached. I think I have some onagers or something. Or I did. I mean, we are just taking a massive beating. I don't even know if I have murder holes researched. I don't think I do. I realize, yeah, we are done for. It's not very survivable or realistic at this point that we're gonna survive. But the AI really likes attacking walls for some reason. Steven's got his 80 some units. But hey, we're like, we're gonna fight to the death. We're gonna be the big noobs we are and fight to the death. Those cavalry archers are just like unstoppable at this point. The game is lagging so bad. You have to mass up those onagers. Not that it really matters at this point to say stuff like that. Yeah. I think I'm upgrading the fallback line. Does Steven have villagers? I don't know if he has any villagers. He must have, he built these houses. Oh, they're there. They're building a market. I don't know what he's building that for. He's kind of past the point for that. Oh, I know why he's building it, so he can give me stone. He's gonna give me all the stone back in a second. It's hard to believe at this point, but I still have over 100 population of villagers. And I realize, yeah, we're pretty much done. There you go, so you just gave me all the stone. And let the slaughter commence. I mean, yeah, it's basically Lag City. I mean, they have so many units. Even if we beat the first wave, it's impossible to win. Like, I'm just curious, how many resources did they have? Oh my, the AI had over 10,000 resources stocked up. Even King Philip. I mean, yeah. When they have that much, it's gonna be hard. Steven, though, has got his 81,000 wood. There, I built me 3 castles. Maybe I can get a free few kills. Yeah, we're done for, though. We are done for. I mean, yeah, that's pretty much game. I don't know if you guys like these battles. I kind of want to redo this one. Just, I don't know, there's a lot that we could have... Not that I could have did differently, but a lot that Steven could have done differently at the beginning. I don't know. Do you guys like these? Let me know down below in the comments. There's like a flood of cavalry archers. If you guys want to let me know, it'd be greatly appreciated. And if you want to like and rate and comment and subscribe and all that good stuff and be a fan of the channel. Yeah. So that's going to be that. So, like I said, do all that awesome stuff down below and whatnot. And I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.